गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अ शॉर्ट नोट ऑन द फीमोरल सीथ। सो इट गोज लाइक दिस, राइट अ शॉर्ट नोट ऑन फीमोरल सीथ, फीमोरल केनाल एंड फीमोरल हर्निया। ओके, दिस आई इंक्लूडेड द थ्री थिंग्स बिकॉज दे आर इंटर रिलेटेड विथ ईच अदर। नाउ दिस हैज टू बी रिटर्न इन द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स। ओके, इंट्रोडक्शन, formation, compartments, and then the femoral canal. The details about femoral canal are as its upper end of the femoral canal, the lower end of the femoral canal, boundaries of the upper end, that is the ring, femoral ring, and then the functions of the canal, and lastly applied importance of the canal. Okay, so these are the various points under which we will learn the femoral canal, and in applied importance we will also include the femoral hernia. Okay, femoral. Now if we see the introduction, let us see the first, the introduction of the femoral sheath. Okay, the femoral sheath is a funnel shaped fascial sheath. It is a funnel shaped fascial sheath which covers the initial around 4 centimeters of the femoral vessels as they lie in the femoral triangle, just below that of the inguinal ligament, inferior to the inguinal ligament. So it is a fascial sleeves covering to the initial part of the femoral vessel, that is artery and the femoral vein. Okay, femoral vein. Now if you see this sheath in the femoral triangle, as I am pointing here in the diagram outline, its lateral margin is vertical and its medial margin is oblique. Just for orientation, this is pubic symphysis, this is pubic tubercle, this is anterior superior allic spine. So this is the inguinal ligament, okay, extending between the two bony points like anterior superior allic spine and the pubic tubercle. Now these are the vessels which come out from deep to that of the inguinal ligament. This is the femoral artery coming almost from the mid inguinal point. Okay, so this is the femoral artery coming out deep to that of the inguinal ligament. And then this is, just a minute, let me find my, yes, this is the blue pencils. I will draw the femoral vein which lies medial to the femoral artery. Okay, so this is all this structure, both these structures, they are covered by the fascial sleeve. Okay, and if I draw the fascial sleeve here, I am just drawing an interrupted line here. Okay, this will cover the initial 4 centimeter or 3.5 centimeter of these both vessels. Its lateral wall is straight, but its medial wall is oblique. Okay, and this covers completely from anterior and posterior aspect, because it is a sleeve. Okay, to these of the initial part of the femoral vessels. This is thus the femoral sheath covering to the. It is a fascial sheath covering to the initial part of the blood vessel. Let us see how it is formed, how the femoral sheath is formed. Now in the formation of the femoral sheath, this sheath is anteriorly formed by the fascia transversalis, and fascia transversalis is present deep to the transversus abdominis muscle. Okay, so let me draw it. These three muscles of the anterior abdominal wall, this is the external oblique abdominis, right? This muscle, deep to which will lie the internal oblique abdominis, and still deeper the third muscle, flat muscle of the anterior abdominal wall, is the transversalis. Okay, so external oblique abdominis, and this is the internal oblique, and this is the transverse abdominis. These are the three wall, I'm say three flat muscles of the anterior abdominal wall. The external oblique abdominis, as you will trace it later down, its fascial sheath will turn up and form the ligament called as the inguinal ligament. So this is the Aponeurosis of the external oblique abdomen is which lower down will form a ligament called as the inguinal. So this is the ligament, inguinal ligament extending between the pubic tubercle, and this is that aponeurosis of the external oblique abdomen is muscle, which its upturned part, lower part will form this ligament. Right, this much you have understood, okay? So this is a fascia transversalis, is a facial sheath which lies the under surface of this muscle called as the transversus abdominis. Then deep to that of the inguinal ligament, it is prolonged on to the blood vessels and going almost to the 3.5 to 4 centimeter below that of the inguinal ligament. So this is on anterior aspect. The facial sheath which forms the femoral sheath is formed by the transversus fascia, and then on the posterior aspect this sheath is formed by another fascia called as the fascia iliacus, which covers the iliacus muscle. This muscle is the iliacus muscle onto the posterior wall, okay, in the iliac fossa of the hip bone. You have learned this is the iliacus muscle which is covered by the fascia iliacus. So these two fascia, fascia transversalis and fascia iliacus, they will be going along with the blood vessel, that is artery and vein, for some distance in this part. Otherwise in its lateral part and in its medial part, both the fascia, they will blend with each other, will not be prolonging. Only in this small part where the blood vessels are coming, they are also coming along with this of the blood vessel. Which vessels? I mean, say which fascia? Fascia iliacus and fascia transversalis. And this is the, say for example, the section is passing through the femoral vein. So this is femoral vein. This is the external iliac vein inside the abdominal cavity, continuous as the femoral vein. Okay, so this is the femoral vein on which these two fascias are blending and fusing with the tunica adventitial layer of the blood vessels. Okay, these two vessels. Okay, now if you cut a section here, a theoretical section passing through the inguinal ligament and deeply with the two vessels, so this will cut the facial sheath, that is the femoral sheath, okay? And then you can see it like this. This is just a theoretical diagram, again for orientation. This is pubic symphysis, pubic crest, pubic tubercle, anterior superior iliac spine, and that's why this is a cut section of the inguinal ligament. Okay, this is the cut section of the inguinal ligament, and then this from pubic tubercle going deep down is the pectin pubis or pectineal line bone, and from this surface or line also taking origin is the pectineus muscle. Pectineus muscle is taking, and from the under surface of the inguinal or deeper surface of the inguinal ligament right up to that of the pectin pubis or pectineal line, lateral to this pubic tubercle, there extend a ligament called as the lacunar ligament. So this is a triangular lacunar ligament which is attached to the inguinal ligament on its deeper aspect, and this is called as lacunar ligament. Okay, and then okay, this blood vessels which are coming deep to the inguinal ligament, okay, this is the artery, that is the femoral artery, and this is the femoral vein. Let's see this femoral vein. This is the femoral vein which is coming here, and these two things, they are bringing along with them the fascia, that is the fascia transversalis anteriorly, this is fascia transversalis anteriorly, and fascia iliacus posteriorly. The sheath is brought, okay, in the triangle, and at its lateral end these two fascia, they blend, so they blend also medially. Okay, now this funnel shaped femoral sheath, okay, in transverse section you can appreciate that it is divided into three compartments with the help of the septa. So there is a septa passing between fascia iliacus and the fascia transversalis, which just separate the vein from the artery. Okay, so this is an lateral septum. Then there is a median septum which also separate two compartment of this sheath, that is the femoral vein or middle compartment and a medial compartment which is an empty compartment. Okay, so the femoral sheath, which is a funnel shaped sheath, okay, which encloses femoral artery and femoral vein, divided into three compartments. Okay, so sheath is divided into three compartments. The lateral compartment contains the femoral artery, just I will write in femoral artery. So it is femoral artery, this is vein, femoral vein, and then the medial part is occupied just only by a canal, and this canal on its medial side is called as femoral canal. So three compartments of the femoral sheath. Okay, the medial most compartment is just empty, nothing passes except few lymphatics occupied by the fibrofatty tissue and one or two small lymph nodes. This is the femoral canal. That compartment is of that of the femoral canal. This canal, as I said, is occupied only by lymph nodes, very small lymph node, lymphatic vessel. And which lymphatic vessel? These are those vessels which are connecting the deep inguinal group of lymph node with that of the iliac group of the lymph node in the abdominal. So all the lymph of the deep inguinal group of lymph node is drained by the lymphatics which are passing through the femoral canal to the abdominal cavity, to the iliac group of lymph node. Okay, now this canal, if you see in the whole extent, this we have seen in a transverse section, but if you will see in the extent, whole, okay, profile, if you are seeing from the top, you will see that this canal, if you trace it down below, it blends with that of the tunica adventitia of the vein, the femoral vein. It blends, it fuses with that. So the canal is co-close below. Okay, so the lower end of the canal is thus below. But if you trace this canal upward, okay, this canal is open upward. Okay, and where it is opening? It is opening in the abdominal cavity, only separated by abdominal cavity by peritoneum and extra fat, extra fibrofatty tissue outside the peritoneum, extra peritoneal fat, I mean to say. Otherwise, this canal is a oval ring-shaped canal which is open on the top, and that is called as the ring, femoral ring. Okay, this will be called as femoral ring. Now this ring, okay, this ring is the potential site, okay, which opens in the abdomen, femoral ring, okay, through which the abdominal contents can come into this canal. They can come into the canal, okay, they can push their way through this canal because it is a empty canal, occupied only by fibrofatty tissue and lymphatics, sometime a small lymph node. Okay, and this may give rise to a hernia, what is called as the femoral hernia. So through the femoral canal, the ring can give passage to the abdominal content. Now if you see the boundary of this ring, which is in the abdominal cavity, okay, which is open in the abdominal cavity, okay, its boundary will be then can be seen and appreciated with this diagram. Canal is anteriorly bounded by what? This was the inguinal ligament. So this is the inguinal ligament. So anteriorly the canal is bounded by the inguinal ligament, okay. Laterally it is bounded by the femoral vein, by septa, okay, or just it is the femoral vein which lies on to its the lateral side, okay, of the femoral canal. Medially it is bounded by this ligament, which we have said that it is the lacunar ligament. So medially by lacunar ligament, laterally by the inguinal canal, and anteriorly by the inguinal ligament. Okay, inguinal canal, I'm sorry, laterally by the femoral vein, anteriorly by the inguinal ligament, medially by the lacunar ligament, and posteriorly, what? Posteriorly, this is bounded, I mean say, on the fascia, iliacus resting onto the pectineus muscle. Okay, fascia covering the pectineus, that muscle here. So these are the boundaries. So you must have realized that this is a very small canal, hardly 1 centimeter, hardly 1 centimeter. Okay, and even with this small size, sometime the contents may come out and give a femoral hernia. Now this femoral hernia, if we see, it is more common in females. And why it is more common in females? Okay, because the first factor is that the pelvic cavity, okay, or pelvis itself is quite wide in case of the female as compared to male. So the size of canal is bigger as compared to that of male. Secondly, those ladies who are obese, fatty, okay, they are having the abdominal contents are heavy, they will try to push through this small space, the femoral canal. And because they are usually lax and weak because of the pregnancy, okay, and because of the weakening of the abdominal muscles, this canal becomes weak, wide, okay. So the inguinal ligament itself become weak, okay, and so that contents may get entry inside the gap, okay, between through the inguinal canal, okay, inguinal canals, right. Now, if the hernia has taken place through this small canal, then to push back the contents of this hernia is difficult, okay, because this is a narrow canal. The loop of intestine, if it has come, okay, then to push it back is difficult because here it is under compression. The blood vessels are compressed, so the part of the intestine which is outside this canal can get due to strangulation also the blood supply may cut off, okay. Now to reduce this hernia, reduce means to push back these contents of the hernia deep inside the abdominal cavity, what can be done is that you have to increase the size of femoral canal, and this is done by cutting the lacunar ligament, because this is just a ligament of no use at such. And if you will cut this lacunar ligament, the size of the canal will increase. But only danger is that sometime on the surface of this lacunar ligament, there lies an artery called as accessory obturator artery. And this artery may cut, leading to a lot of bleeding, okay? Lot of the bleeding which can take place. Now coming to the function of the canal, if we see the function of the canal, this canal, femoral canal, provide any space, and this space I may be utilized by the dilated femoral vein. In case if the femoral vein gets dilated because of the venous return is not proper, the vein will get dilated. So the vein can push this, push itself towards the femoral canal, can accommodate itself in the femoral canal. That is a advantage of having the femoral canal. Okay, and secondly, I told you already that this is the passage through which lot of lymphatics connecting the deep inguinal group of lymph node to that of the deeper lymph node, the external iliac group of lymph nodes are passing through this space. Okay, they are passing through this space. So this is the function of the canal, and in applied importance, I have told you that this is in relation to the femoral hernia, which I have already covered in short. So this is a short note on femoral sheath, femoral canal, and the femoral hernia. Thank you very much for watching this video.